Everybody's got a blank page, a story they're writing today. A wall that
Hi, my name is Colby. I'm 19. I'm from Steinbach. My parents had me when they were in their teen years. My dad pursued it, alcohol, drugs, and the life that came with it, where my mother decided to raise me. She got married when I was about 4, and I grew up calling another man dad, even though I knew who my biological father was. Every time I go see my dad, he'd be drinking or doing some sort of illegal activity, and watching that growing up, that played an impact on my life. When he became a born-again Christian when I was about 13, everything I knew what made me a man all of a sudden was the wrong thing to do. I followed in his footsteps. I started smoking marijuana when I was about 13, and from there it grew worse and worse throughout the years, to the point where when I reached high school I was lying to my parents every day, stealing from them and doing whatever it took to get high, to get me feeling numb. I ended up getting kicked out of high school, and instead of pursuing an education, I decided to choose the gang life and what followed with that. I left my parents' house when I was 17 or so. It just made my situation worse and worse, to the point where I got arrested this last summer for assault. I thought that was my rock bottom. I got signed up for a different program. It just didn't work out. I ended up relapsing, even more angry than before, depressed, to the point where I attempted suicide, and that was finally my rock bottom. I signed up for Teen Challenge in the hospital. I came into Teen Challenge September 28th, 2014. From the moment I walked through those doors, I felt a love that I had never really felt before from one of the students at the time, who is now one of my best friends. And from there, I knew there was something in this building, but I didn't know what it was, but I knew I wanted it. And through my time here, I accepted Christ when I was about a week in, October 6th. November 16th, I got baptized. But it wasn't until about 4 months later that I was fully able to die to my old self. I realized that Jesus was the only answer, and that he was who I wanted to live the rest of my life for. And since then, there's been a change, not just in my own life, but in my family's life. There's a genuine happiness there now. Now that I'm done the program, I'm going to be staying on with Teen Challenge to work with Pastor Terry in the Outreach and Evangelism Department. And I consider it a huge blessing, considering my age and still having the future ahead of me. And Teen Challenge has poured so much into my life, and they're just here beside me, wanting to grow with me. And I just want to thank Pastor James, Chris Dirksen, like Mike Cook, Mike Lee, Ben Luke, guys that gave me all the discipline that I got. I wouldn't be here without you. Pastor Bruce, Sister Ellen for the classes, and Pastor Terry for all the work he put in my life. And I just want to thank all the family and support I had on the outside. I wouldn't be here without you guys for all the encouragement, and just for the churches helping me get in here. 2 Corinthians 4 verse 18 says, "So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but what is unseen. Since what is seen is only temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. There is nothing in this world that will make me as happy as I am with Jesus Christ today. I can truly say my best day high isn't comparable to my worst day with Christ.
No matter what you've gone through, Jesus, he gave it all to save you. He carried the cross on his shoulders so you could start over."